Hi, my name is Patrick Boyle. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, where we learn all about derivatives and quantitative finance. If this is the first video you're watching, make sure that you click the subscribe button to see more content like this. By the end of this video, you'll know what the Monte Carlo method is, how it works, how it differs from the traditional methods for pricing options, and when should you use it and when should you not. Monte Carlo methods are used in finance to value and analyze complex financial instruments by simulating the various sources of uncertainty affecting their value, and then determining their average value over a large range of resultant outcomes or paths. Okay, so what does that mean? It means that rather than using a lot of financial theory to price complex financial instruments, we instead build a computer simulation of the moving parts and see, with enough runs of the model, what the fair value of the financial instrument is. The Monte Carlo options pricing method was developed by Boyle in 1977. It's often considered a method of last resort by market practitioners. The approach is particularly useful in the valuation of options with multiple sources of uncertainty, or with complicated features which would make them difficult or impossible to value through a Black-Scholes-style partial differential equation, or through lattice-based approaches like the binomial tree. The technique is widely used in valuing path-dependent structures like look-back and Asian options, and in what is known as real options analysis. I'll put a link above to my video explaining what real options are. Historically, Monte Carlo methods were considered to be too slow to be competitive, but with the faster computing capability today, this constraint is way less of a concern. Okay, so how does it work? Well, let's start with an idea taken from gambling and probability. If you had two dice that you were going to roll, the range of results that you could get would be any number between 2 and 12. The lowest number 2 is what you get if you roll two ones, and the highest number 12 comes from rolling two sixes. Now, obviously, with one dice, you can get anything between 1 and 6, and the probability of any of those outcomes is equal. It's 1 over 6, which is 16.7% chance. However, with the two dice, you are most likely to roll a 7. Let me explain. This is because there is only one way to roll a 2 and one way to roll a 12, where in order to roll a 2, you have to roll two ones, and in order to roll a 12, you have to roll two sixes. Now, in order to get a score of 4, for example, with two dices, this can be achieved by rolling a 1 and a 3, a 2 and a 2, or a 3 and a 1. You have to consider the two dice separately, so even though the result is the same, a 1 on the first die and a 3 on the second die, is actually a different outcome from a 3 on the first die and a 1 on the second die. For two dice, 7 is the most likely result, with 6 different ways that we're able to achieve that. In this case, probability equals 6 divided by 36, giving 16.7% chance. You can see a histogram on screen right now showing the probabilities of each roll. So why am I telling you all of this? Well, because there's two ways that we could work out these probabilities. One is the mathematical way that I just described, where we analyzed the problem and worked out numerically what the answer was. But the other, simpler and maybe more brute force approach, would be quite simply to get two dice, roll them 5,000 times, for example, and note down the numbers that we've rolled each time. The Monte Carlo model uses that type of approach, the brute force approach, and uses it to price derivatives. The Monte Carlo method involves simulating the underlying process followed by the various risk factors affecting the price of the derivative that we are trying to price. First, you generate a price path for the underlying based upon the random movements of the various risk factors, and calculate the payoff from the derivative based on that path. The image you see on screen right now shows you what those simulated price paths might look like. Then you repeat these steps, generating numerous sample values of the payoff from the derivative in the future. Once you have done that, you simply calculate the average of the sample payoffs, giving an estimate of the derivative's expected payoff in a risk-neutral world. Finally, you discount the payoff at the risk-free rate. This result is the fair value of the option today. The number of iterations carried out is at the discretion of the operator and depends on the required accuracy. It is usual to calculate the standard deviation of the discounted payoffs generated by the simulation. The uncertainty about the value of the derivative is inversely proportional to the square root of the number of iterations that you run. So, when do you use the Monte Carlo method? The Monte Carlo method can have great flexibility. Complex stochastic processes, including jumps, mean reversion, or both, can be accommodated, and different distributions, including changing distributions, can be assumed. The Monte Carlo method is generally used when there are three or more stochastic variables, which make using a PDE or a lattice-based approach extremely difficult or impossible. Monte Carlo in these situations can be more efficient than other approaches, as the time taken to run a Monte Carlo simulation increases in a linear manner with the number of variables, where for most other methods, the time taken increases exponentially with the number of variables. The Monte Carlo method is a brute force approach to pricing options. It does not rely on a lot of financial theory. It simply uses computer power to simulate thousands of possible price paths for the underlying. The Monte Carlo method is by no means free of assumptions, though. You always have to assume a distribution for the driving asset, as well as structure for its volatility, and the absence or existence of jumps. The beauty of the Black-Scholes and lattice-based approaches is that they not only give you a fair value for the option, but they also specify a trading strategy, like delta hedging, which allows you to hedge your risk exposures. If you have not watched my videos explaining dynamic replication, you should probably watch those to understand how important that is to an options trader. Most of the options that require the Monte Carlo method to price are close to impossible to hedge, or at least very difficult to hedge accurately. And for this reason, the option is usually sold only when the buyer will pay well above fair value, as the seller usually has to keep that option on their books for its entire lifespan and can only roughly hedge it. Advantages of the Monte Carlo method are that it can be used not only to price options where the payoff depends on the final price of the underlying on the expiration date, but also when the payoff depends on the price path followed by the underlying. The Monte Carlo method can similarly be used to value options where the payoff depends on the value of multiple underlying assets, such as basket options or rainbow options. Take a look at my videos on exotic options and structured products to understand those. In pricing those derivatives, correlation between asset returns is also incorporated. The Monte Carlo method allows for compounding in the uncertainty, such as where a joint probability distribution is used. In the case of only two random variables, this is called a bivariate distribution, but the concept generalizes to any number of random variables, giving a multivariate distribution. An example would be pricing an option on a stock in a foreign currency, where the paths followed by the underlying stock and the exchange rate have to be modeled, but also the correlation between these two sources of risk must be incorporated. The Monte Carlo method cannot easily handle situations where there is early exercise. In these situations, a least square Monte Carlo method with a backward induction approach is used. So how do we calculate the Greeks when using the Monte Carlo method? Calculating the Greeks using the Monte Carlo method is usually done by first pricing the derivative and then recalculating the price of the derivative after making a small change in the input, such as spot price, to calculate delta, or volatility if we are calculating vega, whose price sensitivity it is we are trying to find. The same number of iterations should be run in calculating the new price as were used when initially pricing the derivative. All of these videos are based on my book, Trading and Pricing Financial Derivatives, which is available on Amazon.com. I've put a link to it in the description below. Hit the like button to let me know if you found this video helpful, and hit the subscribe button and the bell button next to it in order to see more videos like this in your feed. Have a great day. Bye.